Dr. Khan, thank you for being with us. Help us understand, first of all, what this virus is and how it's connected to this brain damage in children in utero.
Thank you very much. So as you heard, Zika is a mosquito-borne virus. It's spreading explosively in the Americas right now, and it is associated with this tragic outbreak of newborns who are born with abnormally small heads and brain and other defects. Now, this virus, for 50 years, it was a rare cause of a mild fever illness that occurred in a narrow belt in Africa and Southeast Asia. And then in about 2007, it went rogue and it spread across the Pacific into Brazil. And now, as you heard, there's been about 500,000 to 1.5 million cases in Brazil.
I think what's most concerning to people is the fact that there's no cure. There's not even a vaccine right now. What can people do to try to protect themselves other than just trying not to get bit by a mosquito? Because we should just clarify, being bitten by a mosquito is the only way to contract this.
Being bitten by a mosquito is the main way to contract this. There is some probably rare evidence that you could also get this from blood transfusions or potentially from person-to-person transmission, but those are real anecdotal cases. How you get infected is by getting bit by a mosquito, and how you protect yourself is everything you do to keep from getting bit by a mosquito, whether it's for West Nile disease or whether it's from Zika virus. So that means repellents, that means long sleeves, long pants, and try to get rid of all standing water around where you are.
Well, and the cases here in the U.S. seem to be expanding of what we're seeing. I'm sure a lot of people are looking at this wondering, how susceptible are we here in the U.S. to some sort of epidemic?
And we should expect the cases to expand because they're expanding in the Americas. But the important thing here is that the cases we see here in the United States are not from local transmission in the United States. These are people who have traveled to the Americas and then have come back and have been diagnosed with Zika virus. And so we see this for malaria. We see this for lots of diseases that occur elsewhere. Obviously, a disease anywhere is a disease everywhere. Now, within the United States, we do have these same type of mosquitoes that are transmitting the disease in, for example, Mexico and the Caribbean. But we've been very fortunate so far that these mosquitoes have not picked up the virus and are causing transmission locally.
Okay, I only have about 30 seconds, but I did want to ask you, for people who are watching this, and we know what happens to babies in utero and who are born with this, what about young children or people who are just out and about? Is there any serious risk in that regard?
As far as we know, except for people who are pregnant, this causes a mild illness with a fever, a headache, maybe some red eyes and some joint pains that gets better in about 3 to 5 days.